And it's a new era, isn't it, now for Coach Mark D'Antonio, the post-heart attack era. And for some people, a situation like this can, I think, drastically change their life. And why wouldn't it? After all, Dr. Greg Landis, cardiovascular surgeon, Total Vein Care Clinic, is with us here in our Gillespie Group storefront studio. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Michael Patrick.
There was no reason to think that Mark D'Antonio would have a heart attack. He's a picture of health. He's 53 years old, slender as a rail. I'm told he eats salads, doesn't smoke, has no history of heart problems. How can this happen?
Well, the one thing that you can't control, and there's five causes or underlying reasons to have buildup of plaque in your arteries, and that's diabetes, smoking, elevated cholesterol and triglycerides in the blood. And then the one thing you can't change is your parents' genes, so he may have a genetic predisposition. Stress can be a secondary cause. We do see higher incidence of coronary artery disease in people with stressful jobs, undercover cops, soldiers that are in combat, and things like that, radio hosts, surgeons. you think about it, stress can be, but it depends how you handle it, and everybody's a little bit different.
Well, I mean, could it be? Could that situation against Notre Dame have been so stressful that it triggered something like this, or would it? Was it destined to happen anyway?
It probably destined to happen anyway. I don't know what his excitement level was at the end of the game. He kind of had that wry smile, which you talked about earlier.
Yeah.
And I, you know, when I reflect back, looking at that, you know, was it, you know, a smile of, you know, he had the little Giants play, or was it, you know, he wasn't feeling comfortable? It was kind of an odd.
And I thought so, too.
If you looked at his interview with the sideline chick that comes up at the end of the game, he really wasn't that verbal. He was, like, kind of quick to the point, and he was out of there. And usually they spend time after a game. He'd be jumping up and down and, you know, have a
yeah.
great time.
In fact, he ended the interview, it seemed like, a little early. He just kind of said, okay, well, everybody have a good night, and he took off.
Right. And it was shortly, I guess he got to Sparrow about 12:30, and the game ended about midnight. So, and he had his procedure done at 2 a.m. So it's... It's pretty quick, and it was nice that you know, the facilities are available. That, you know, you go right in, you got chest pain, and you're taken to the cath lab, and they inserted a stent, just one stent, and it fixed his problem.
That's not done through an open heart situation.
Not at all. It's done through a catheter. We put a catheter into the main artery, usually in the groin, and they run the catheter up through that artery into the aorta, up to the coronary artery.
It's common.
Done thousands of times a year.
He said that he was feeling tightening in the chest.
That's a common symptom. You have kind of a pressure, like an elephant sitting on your chest.
Mm-hmm.
Some people feel like a pressure or a pain down their arm or up into their jaw. Some people feel pain between their shoulder blades and the back. A lot of people have like a pit in their stomach, like they got indigestion.
And could you feel that and miss it? Or is it so severe that you know this is not my everyday run-of-the-mill ache and pain?
It's If a main artery shuts off, you're going to feel it. But a smaller one, and I don't know exactly the anatomy, which artery was stented, but you could feel the pain and not be that crushing. And men typically will kind of blow it off. Oh, it's something I ate, or, you know,
yeah,
just not feeling good.
That's what I'm thinking. But this would be so severe that even the average person wouldn't blow it off.
What he experienced, I don't know. I don't know exactly how he felt. Like I say, when I... You know, reflect back to that interview. He just wasn't quite right, and I don't know if he was just trying to, you know, hide that fact.
Does it build slowly like that, or does it just happen?
It can come on like a ton of bricks.
It can.
Yeah, but some people have what we call angina, which is just pains that come and go, and usually it's with exercise or some kind of activity, and it goes away once you rest. So people can have that symptom as well, which is the same thing as chest pain.
They say he'll be in the hospital a couple days more. Is that the standard length of time?
Well, I think they want to make sure that his heart damage is minimal. I'm sure they've drawn a lot of labs and gone to see what it looks like in a couple of days. Usually it's day 3 to 5 after a heart attack that can be the most dangerous point. Especially if it's a significant heart attack, because then the muscle isn't working correctly and you can have some problems. But from everything that I've heard and talked to some of my colleagues, it was a very minor heart attack.
Likely that he'll go back to work?
Oh, yeah. I can see probably not this weekend, but the next weekend.
Boy, that's interesting. And when you start to add up these coaches, and I don't know if it's just a coincidence, but Urban Meyer has health problems. He's a very intense coach. You think back to Bo Schembechler. His first Rose Bowl had a heart attack the night before the game.
Exactly. And he's had a couple of, I think he had 3 different heart surgeries for his problems.
It's an intense job, clearly.
Exactly.
So will he have to change? I mean, I don't know how you change your lifestyle when you're already a salad eater and you don't smoke and you're a picture of health. I mean, what will he have to do?
Well, I'd imagine just keep doing as you're doing it, and he'll just be, you know, routinely checked with stress tests and those kind of things. Again, I don't know his genetic situation. I don't know if his parents or whatever had a problem with coronary artery disease, but that is the other factor.
So there are a lot of probably 53-year-old guys listening right now. It's just kind of how the demographic breaks out. But what should we think after this? What should we be aware of, or can you do anything to avoid it?
Well, if you have a new onset of chest pain, I get it checked out. I wouldn't blow it off. Mm-hmm. But, definitely seek a physician, and probably most likely to give you a stress test to see if everything's okay.
If you have a stress test, because I had one this summer in the spring, and everything was okay, mm-hmm. how long does that last? How long do I have to go back and get another check?
It depends on your risk factors, you know.
A mm-hmm. Couple weeks?
You don't want to do it every 2 weeks.
Okay, good, because it's not that much fun, but they tell me it's invaluable.
That's correct.
Very good thing to do.
Yep.
Well, thank you very much for being with us
You're welcome.
This morning. We'll talk again when we get closer to the Ohio State game, as always.
At the end of the year.
You bet. And where it will stay, as we understand, even under the new Big Ten alignment, the Michigan-Ohio State game. Dr. Greg Landis, cardiovascular surgeon with the Total Vein Care Clinic in the Lansing area. People come from around the state to see him. 14 before the hour.